Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss quadratic functions and models. Let's look at an example of a quadratic function, and we're going to graph it and find everything. So consider f of x equals x squared minus 4x minus 12. We're going to sketch the graph and find the intercepts, the vertex, the axis of symmetry, the domain, the range, and the max or the min. Let's carefully work through this solution. So we'll start by finding the intercepts. Let's start by finding the y-intercept. So y-int. To find the y-intercept, all you do is plug in 0 for your x. So you get f of 0, and that's equal to, so we're going to put zeros everywhere we see an x. So 0 squared minus 4 times 0 minus 12. That's going to be f of 0 equals minus 12. So as an ordered pair, the y-intercept will be x comma y, so the x is 0 and the y is negative 12. So that would be our y-intercept. Let's go ahead and find the x-intercepts. X int. To find the x-intercepts of any function, all you do is you take your entire function and you set it equal to 0. So we have x squared minus 4x minus 12, and we set that equal to 0. And we should be able to factor this. Let's try to do it by guessing. So I'll put a parenthesis in an x, parenthesis in an x, and this is equal to 0. So we need two numbers that multiply to negative 12, but add to negative 4. So it looks like negative 6 and a positive 2 should do it, because negative 6 times 2 is negative 12, yep, and negative 6 plus 2 is negative 4. Looks good. We have a product equal to 0, so you set each factor equal to 0, so you get x minus 6 equals 0, or x plus 2 is equal to 0. In the first equation, we can add 6 to both sides, so we get x equals 6. That's one of our x-intercepts. I'm going to put it in a box. And in the second equation, we subtract 2, so we get x equals minus 2. That is our second x-intercept, so I will put it in a box. We found the intercepts pretty easy. Again, to find the y-intercept, you plug in 0 for x. To find the x-intercept, you take your entire function and you set it equal to 0. This is true in any case. Like, even if it's not a quadratic function, this is how you find the x and y-intercepts, which is very, very useful. All right, let's go to the vertex. This is very specific to our particular function. So to find the vertex, I'm going to go ahead and just rewrite our function down here so we have it. F of x equals x squared minus 4x minus 12. And so the general form of a quadratic function is the following. It would be f of x equals ax squared plus bx plus c. People call this the general form. Sometimes they call it the standard form. It varies by textbook. In any case, you can write a quadratic function in this form. And using this form, you can identify the a and the b. So a is the coefficient of x squared. So a is equal to 1. And then b is the coefficient of x. So b is equal to negative 4. You don't need c. It's a habit. If you write c down, it's okay. In the quadratic equation, you need c, but here you don't. And so basically what you do now is you compute this quantity. It's x equals negative b over 2a. This is the formula. Super useful, okay? We're finding the vertex. So you have to identify a, identify b, and then you plug them into this formula. So this is negative negative 4 over 2 times a, so 2 times 1. This will be 4 over 2, which is equal to 2. So x is equal to 2. By the way, this is the axis of symmetry. I'm just going to go ahead and put it in a box and call it axis. So we find the axis along the way when we're finding the vertex. So the equation x equals 2 is the axis of symmetry. Let's keep finding the vertex though. So you compute this, you get x equals 2, then you take this number and you plug it into your function. So I'm going to do that over here. Then we have f of 2 is equal to 2 squared minus 4 times 2 minus 12. So f of 2 is equal to 4 minus 8 minus 12. So it's going to be 4 minus 8 minus 12. So f of 2 is equal to, going to be 4 minus 20. So it's going to be minus 16. So now we have our vertex as an ordered pair. It's going to be, I'm going to write vertex so we have it on the screen. It's going to be 2 comma negative 16. That's going to be our vertex right there. Okay, so we've got our axis, we've got our vertex. Again, to find the vertex, you identify A and B. So here A was 1, B was negative 4. Plug them into this formula, x equals negative b over 2a. The answer you get, x equals that answer, is the axis. And you take this number, plug it into your function, and then that gives you the y-coordinate of the vertex. We're ready to go. We're ready to do the graph. Let's just do it. So here's the y-axis. And this is not going to be a perfect graph. Okay, I'm not going to draw it to scale. And then here we have the x-axis. Get a better line there. The y, if you have a ruler, you can use a ruler, you know, to make the lines a little bit better. So let's plot what we have. We have some intercepts. Let me just go back up here and look to see. We've got a y-intercept of 0, negative 12. Okay, so that's, I'm not going to use tick marks for that because that's a lot of tick marks. So I'm just going to do this. I'm going to put it here and I'll say negative 12. And then we've got x-intercepts at 6 and at negative 2. So I will go ahead and use tick marks for those. So let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then 1, 2, it was negative 2. So these are the x-intercepts. Let's just double check. 6 and negative 2. And then we have a vertex at 2, negative 16. So that's going to be maybe down here. Maybe I should put it a little bit closer. There we go, like right there. That's a little bit better. And this would be 2, negative 16. Negative 16. There we go. And now we can sketch the graph. I'm going to use a different color for the graph. So basically, we have to draw what looks like a parabola. So it looks something like this. And you just do your best. Connect the dots. As long as the important points are labeled and it's clear to the reader what they are, you know, you don't have to be a great artist, but you can see clearly from the picture the x-intercepts are negative 2 and 6, the y-intercept is negative 12, and the vertex is right here. Now we can find the domain. The domain is all of the x's that you can plug into this function. Well, all real numbers, there's no issues. If you look at the graph, I can pick any x and I'm going to get a y value. There's no issues. There's nothing funky going on. So the domain is negative infinity to infinity. Also, if you look at your function, f of x equals x squared minus 4x minus 12. There's no fractions or anything, so all is good. Your range is going to be, well, the smallest possible y value is negative 16. And you want to include it, so you use a bracket, and it goes all the way to infinity. Okay? And as far as the minimum, there's a minimum. Minimum is the smallest y value, so the minimum is negative 16. Negative 16 is the smallest y value. It occurs at the vertex, so it occurs at 2, negative 16. Just extra knowledge. That's where it happens. The actual minimum value is negative 16, but it occurs at 2, negative 16. Right, so that's pretty much it. Oh, I should mention something else. At the beginning of the problem, when we saw the question, you could tell right away it's going to have a minimum, because if you look here at x squared, a is equal to 1, which is bigger than 0, but opens up, so you're going to have a min. If a is less than 0, it opens down, and then you have a max. Okay, so hopefully this problem has helped you learn some math. It certainly does include a lot of math. We have to find all the intercepts, and then we had to find the vertex, the axis of symmetry, which, by the way, is just a vertical dotted line. It looks like this. Cuts it right in half. That's why it's called axis of symmetry. And we found the domain and the range. So, yeah, I hope you've learned some math. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Good luck.